Right now, I'm going to show you how to have unprecedented control over color LUTs inside of Photoshop. Hey, Cafe crew, Colin Smith here from PhotoshopCafe.com. Right now, let's jump in and use color LUTs, which are incredible for applying these looks to our images. And then I'm going to show you how to make adjustments that you probably couldn't make before. So here's an image I grabbed from Adobe Stock. Let's just go to our layers panel and we're going to use an adjustment layer. So if you click on the adjustments and then you're going to go to color lookup, this is where all the LUTs are. If I click here, it's going to pop open in the properties panel. Now click on where it says load 3D LUT and you'll see the LUTs come with Photoshop. I have some extras and at the end I'll show you how to get those. So we're going to go under the Filmic Cube, which is a LUT that I made, and I'm going to apply it. Now here's the problem with LUTs. The only adjustment I have is to change the opacity to change the strength of the LUT. What I'm looking for is a way to control the color and the tone individually, and guess what? I've figured out. Of course I have. That's what I'm showing you on this video. So the trick is actually quite simple. What I want to do is just take that LUT that I've applied and I'm going to duplicate it. So I'm going to do sort of like a frequency separation for color and tone. So let's duplicate it, Control J. So obviously right now it's doubled up, but here's where the secret is. In the top here, we're just gonna do tone, and then we're gonna call this one color. You don't even have to rename them. I'll just do this for the sake of what we're doing here. So I only wanna affect the tone, not the color. So let's go to the layer blending mode, choose normal, and go all the way down to luminosity. Now we're going to go to the next one that says color, and let's change the blend mode once again. Click on normal, go down to color. So what I've done here is essentially split that LUT into two. Why don't I just select them both and hit Control G just to put them into a group? And I just want to show you. So I'm just going to duplicate this. Don't worry about this is not part of the lesson. I just want to show you. So if we look at the LUT, here's the LUT in normal mode. That's what we've applied. And then if we split it into two, it looks exactly the same. This is very much like what we do for frequency separation. But now we can go in under the tone. I can take the luminosity all the way to zero. I can go to color, take the slider all the way to zero. And now here's our original image. And now we can go in and choose just the amount of color we want. So now as I increase this opacity, I'm dialing in the color because maybe that's too much. We want to adjust it. And notice how we can choose just the amount of color we want out of this LUT. Same thing for the tone. Now I can go into the tone and dial in just the amount I want. So this has kind of enabled us to hack in and create a separate tone and color slider. Now, if you want to learn more about how to create LUTs and how to load them into the menus, check out the other videos that I've got for you there. I also said I was going to give you some free LUTs. So if you head over to photoshopcafe.com/vault, I've actually got a whole bag of goodies there that you can have for free. So I'm pretty sure you haven't seen this anywhere before because I actually came up with this on my own. Have you guys kind of stumbled across the same thing? Let me know in the comments underneath if this is useful. And by the way, if you're new here, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. Do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps us with the algorithm on YouTube. And don't forget, head back next Tuesday for another quick tip. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.